Greetings. Thank you, Brother Kaneki, for asking your list of topics. This is part 3 in my series answering your questions. Can you tell me this? Point 3. Why does the Bible explain the coming of Mohammed? I would like to answer that assertion in this video, brother. First, let's understand the reason for such an assertion. Mohammed created credentials for himself by claiming he was foretold in the Torah and Bible. Mohammed did this in 2 specific locations in the Quran. But we only need to cover the first claim, which has a description. I won't cover Surah 61:6. Surah 7:157. Those who follow the messenger, the prophet who 1. Can neither read, 2. Nor write, whom they will find described in the Torah and the Gospel, which are with them, he will 3. Enjoin on them that which is right, and 4. Forbid them that which is wrong. 5. He will make lawful for them all good things, and 6. Prohibit for them only the foul. And he will 7. Relieve them of their burden, and the 8. Fetters that they used to wear. 9. Then those who believe in him, and honor him, and help him, and follow the light which is sent down with him, 10. They are the successful. 7:158. Say, O Muhammad, O mankind, lo, I am the messenger of Allah to you all, the messenger of him unto whom belong the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth. There is no Allah save him, he quickeneth and he giveth death. So believe in Allah and his messenger, the prophet who can neither read nor write, who believeth in Allah and in his words, and follow him that haply you may be led aright. Notice that a key part is mentioned twice in the description. A prophet who can neither read nor write. Besides that, I counted 8 more elements describing this prophet and what he would do. Accomplish. Also remember what 7:157 said. They will find described in the Torah and the Gospel, which are with them. The most reasonable interpretation is that the description the Quran says, you will find, is the same one that the Quran gives you to look for. A prophet who can neither read nor write. So, brother, you should first realize that you have been told there are mentions. But for a fact, the Torah and Bible, which contains the Torah, does not contain 1 single mention of a prophet who can neither read nor write. But there are a dozen or so passages Islam tries to twist to look like or fit Muhammad. Deuteronomy 18:15. This does foretell a prophet. He will be from Israel. He will be sent to Israel. This does not mention he cannot read and cannot write. And Jesus said, Moses spoke of me. Deuteronomy 18:18. This does foretell the same prophet as verse 18:15. This does not mention he cannot read and cannot write. It is already known to be fulfilled by Jesus. Deuteronomy 33:2. This verse speaks of God, the Lord, Yahweh. This makes no mention of a prophet, and this makes no mention he cannot read and cannot write. This verse speaks of God, brother, and Islam commits blasphemy when it steals this as speaking of Muhammad. Deuteronomy 34:10. This verse does not speak of a specific prophet. This makes no mention he cannot read and cannot write. This verse addresses that the prophet of Deuteronomy 18 had not yet come, because Jesus, who later fulfills Deuteronomy 18, had not come yet. Song of Solomon 5:16. This does not foretell a prophet. This does not mention he cannot read or cannot write. It describes a Jewish woman in Jerusalem describing her lover. It is in a book Islam reviles as pornographic. Isaiah 29:12. This does not foretell a prophet. This mentions a man who cannot read, but no mention of writing. Men give the unlearned man a sealed book. This does not fit Islam's claim of an angel who gave Mohammed the Quran. John 14, the Comforter. This does not foretell a prophet. This does not mention a man who cannot read and cannot write. The Comforter described by Jesus is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit fulfilled this coming on the day of Pentecost. I have many videos addressing why Muhammad cannot be the Comforter. John 15, the Comforter again. This does not foretell a prophet. This does not mention a man who cannot read and cannot write. The Comforter described by Jesus is the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit fulfilled this coming on the day of Pentecost. John 16, the Comforter. This does not foretell a prophet. It doesn't mention the word prophet. This does not mention a man who cannot read and cannot write. The Comforter described by Jesus is the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit fulfilled this coming on the day of Pentecost. And brother, where Islam cannot find any mention of a prophet who cannot read or write, it then claims any mention of camel, warrior, or other words not in the description must be Muhammad. And it claims the Torah and Bible have been changed. But that is a provably false claim, brother. The Quran claims the description is in the Torah and Bible they had with them. And Christians have whole Bible manuscripts from the time of Muhammad and before. And no Muhammad, no unlearned prophet in any of them. Now, brother, I understand just how important it is to prove Muhammad did not tell lies. And if you have been told Muhammad is mentioned in any other verses, please let me know. Produce your proof, book and chapter and verse. I would love to judge the claim in video form. But as I said when I began this answer, there is no mention of Muhammad in the Bible. And those who claim there is have committed an error, a sin by repeating something that is false. Jesus fulfilled all the mentions of a prophet to come, brother. Jesus even taught that he, the Son, was the last messenger. Matthew 21:37. Last of all, he sent his Son to them. They will respect my Son, he said. Mark 1:6. He had one left to send, a Son, whom he loved. He sent him last of all, saying, they will respect my Son. Jesus very clearly taught there would not be a prophet after God sent his Son. So there is no mention of Muhammad or another prophet in the Bible. The description is simply not there. And that forces you to make a decision, brother, whether you continue to believe the words of a man you cannot verify or not. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.